Morning to my fellow subscribers. So I just arrived in school as early as this time. So I would like to continue our discussion on the chapter 2 of our book, which is entitled Writing Your Thesis and Dissertation Qualitatively, Fear No More. So I hope you have the reviews of our videos, and I hope that this video will help you in journeying to your research or dissertation writing. So we are now in the chapter 2, one year study. So I'm done with letter A, B, C, and D. So this time, we're going to have the letter B, which is finding the gap. Okay, so finding the gap. The gap is the specific aspect of the topic which where you clearly see that new knowledge is needed to contribute to a better understanding of the topic. So although you can easily find a topic, you will need to spend quite some time reading several sources before you come up with a clear gap. So this is especially true for those who are writing dissertations. To find your gap, you may want to think about the following questions. So first, number one, what is not yet known? Okay, so you have to think of the topic or find a topic or a gap that not everything is already known, okay? So you have to find what is not yet known, okay? What is not popular, what is not has been studied before, okay? So that is your focus of your gap if you want to have your topic. Next, letter B, what is not yet researched? So because in this changing world, everything or everyone have different researches, and maybe your topic that you wanted to write about has been researched already. So all you have to do is to find something new, okay? Something that is not yet researched. Okay, let us see what is that everyone keeps missing in the research on this topic. Okay, so the gap, for example, there are existing studies regarding your topic. So you really have to find the gap in between them. And then you're going to find what is the thing that you can do in order to meet that gap or to supply that gap. Okay? It is not a problem when somebody is researching about this topic for as long as you have find the gap, you have found the gap, and then you have to supply it, okay? So that's the point of researching, okay? It's not about the topic has already been known, the topic has been already set and being researched, and then you really have to find a particular gap in order for you to meet the certain point, okay? Next, letter D, what is that everyone keeps failing to explain in the existing research on this topic or in the literature? Because sometimes in the existing researches, there are literature or review of related literature which are not really suitable for the particular topic being cited. So therefore, you have to find it, find this failing part of the research, and then you have to do your own, okay? You have to supply or you have to make it as your own so that you can be able to pursue or you can be able to make something on that particular topic, okay? So even it is already existing topic, however, you really have to find or meet the missing link or the missing part of it, okay? And then that would be your own study. Okay, next, how different is the new phenomenon from what has been written about this topic? Yes, a phenomenon, we know that a phenomenon or a phenomena is something like people are talking about. It's something that is unusual, that many people are clinging to it, or many people are having a discussion about that particular phenomena, okay? This is something new, okay, that people are talking about, something that viral, okay? So if you find one, then you really have to put something or write something in a different way or in different concept or context, okay? To make it your own. Okay, next, letter F, what are the recommended topics for further research in existing literature? Okay, that's why at the end of each research, there's always a part wherein you're going to make a recommendation. So recommendations should be addressed by future researchers, okay? If those researchers have parallel study with you, then they would have met this recommendation that you are making, okay? Letter G, what methodological issues are common in the literature written on this topic? We all know that in writing the thesis or dissertation, there's a lot of methodologies. Okay, one methodology may not fit with other methodologies. So therefore, you have to find another one which suits or which meet which met your or meet your topic. Okay, next is letter H. What assumptions are missing in all the research that's been conducted on this topic so far? Okay, so what are the assumptions? Maybe they lack their assumptions on this particular topic, and then you found one, then that's the start or the beginning that you can do your own research. Okay, so because not all assumptions are correct, okay, there are variations. It varies according to what or who is the person is making that particular assumption. Okay, next, letter I, what contradictions are evident in the current findings of research and currently available on this topic? Yes, if you are pertaining to an existing study and then you have found out that these current findings of research are not available on the topic that you are citing now, then that is the chance for you to make your research. Okay, so you can find a research gap either by reading the existing literature that is different works that have been published about the topic, or by creating one, okay? As what I am telling you earlier, you can really make your own concept. You can create your own topic, okay, based on the existing study. Because researching is evolving. Researching is something you have to find another thing, okay? Even there is a suggested, there are suggested things to do, assumptions and recommendation, all you have to do is really make your own, okay? Then, finding the gap using existing literature is the easier options. So you can simply use the questions above. The second option of creating a new gap requires you to think of something completely new. This is not easy, but it's possible. If you are writing a thesis, you may as well solely consider the first option. It will save you a lot more time. So these guides that I have given you this morning, wherein finding the gap would really help you if you are starting to do your research, okay, or thesis writing, okay? So just bear in mind that in writing researches, in writing your thesis or dissertation, you really have to think of your original work, okay? You don't have to adapt. You don't have to, follow what is existing. You really have to find or create your own topic, okay, to make it original and authentic in a way that this is really your own created craft, okay? So thank you so much for listening this morning, and catch up for more videos on the succeeding days that we will be having. So thank you so much, my subscribers, and for those who have not yet subscribed, just click the button, the red button to subscribe, and then of course you really have to spend about 5 minutes to 10 minutes of your time to view any of this video to have credit on the subscription. Okay, thank you so much, and God bless.